Hi for Monday, August 2nd, and all the market information is in the newsletter, so if you didn't get it in the mail, you can check it on the website, on the main page up at the top right, or in all the menus, actually. There'll be newsletters, and you can go to it there. Okay, so let's just talk about the quick 10 new stocks to the watch list. They're all long, so if we have a pullback, of course, you can use the ETFs. We have an ETF page, by the way, if you don't know. A lot of ETFs have links to the charts, but it does have a big listing of ETFs that are available. First up, on the watch list, AEIS. And you can see back in a week or so ago, we had a big volume day, 2.5 million shares. It moved up here, and then it pulled back. After it got up to the top, it pulled back 3 days. As you know, we like 3 or 4 day reversals. And when they pull back on light volume, as it did here, quite often the third or fourth day will be the big move, and that's what happened on Friday as it moved back up. Now, because of this volume, it's likely that we'll try to break out above there. Now, it can go sideways for 2 days, maybe three, longer than that, and its chances of going up, I think, are diminished insofar as the momentum, because people are watching this. They saw it and they missed it. They wanted to buy when it dropped 3 days. They forgot about it, whatever. And so they're looking, oh, I'm not going to miss it the next time. Now, if it doesn't happen to break soon, then what happens is they forget about it. They get on other stocks. I think that's what happens. Anyway, I've seen it happen so many times. But it's good to watch for the first couple of days. It breaks out above the 1780, 1790 area. If the volume looks strong, the run rate looks there, it may go one more day. In the past, you can see, even though it didn't have such a big moves, it's run up many days in a row over here and over here. And so it's likely that it could happen once again. We got BXS. 1550 is what we're talking about up on the top side here. But you can see the volume's pretty strong. Now, this was a gap down on big volume, so you know these are risky, like maybe it had valid reason to gap down on such a big volume. But at the same time, there's always this force of some people that think, well, investors say it shouldn't have gapped down, it shouldn't have gone down so much. And if they can move above this line, they may fill this gap even, but generally they don't go above that right away. But just going from the point where it is to the gap, experienced traders may find this a possibility. Anyway, we have strong enough interest in this because of the above average volume for 2 days in a row and the decent move up on Friday that we thought we'd point it out to you. CIGX. $2.23 looks like a possibility here. It had good volume 4 days before, and then it came down on light volume. And then Friday, even though Thursday was low volume sideways, Friday was higher volume moving back up. This is not a gap that we're showing here. It's just looking over here. If we look in April, this had a big down day, and this was a low, which became support. So now it should be resistance up above 240. So this little 10% or 9% area in here is tradable. And now it may not be end up to be resistance if it breaks out above there, but we think that this is one area that probably turns out to be tradable, that if it gets into this area, it might likely go up to that 240 or a little bit above that at least, and that would make a fine profit. You know, you don't need big profits every time. Small profits, just make sure you take some often, and that pays out. Now, MFE over 33.45. Over here is 33.44, and it looks like that's a fair entry. It came up to 33.30 on Friday. Look, increase in volume. If we look down at the indicators, we've had for a long time, we've had this positive divergence on the MACD starting back in May, actually. It's been moving up all along, and the stock price has been basically stable. And we've got RSI now above 50. So this looks like now it may not break out right away, and of course it may not ever, but the indications are with a strong volume, there's something going on of interest, and it's the first time it's closed over the 50-day since sometime in April. So with MFE, you know, you can, with Quote Tracker and many programs, you can set an alert, and you set it below the period, then you don't have to watch it, and the alert will pop up or make a sound or send you an email, whatever you like, and then you know to check it, and if the volume run rate looks good, you can buy some. If ever in question, buy less than normal, and then if it picks up and things improve, you can add to it. Okay, we've got ROVI over about $45. Now, $44.85 was the high over here, and the high was $44.96 on Friday. Also, once again, high volume. You can see in the past it's had it fails sometimes. That's why we've shown it here, that it failed this breakout, it pulled back. Then it failed again and it pulled back. And over here, finally, it broke out. Now, maybe it's going to do it now. It came down 2 days. Just like we said, we love 3 or 4 day pullbacks. This is the third day, and the fourth day, it gapped right up. And so maybe something is brewing there. ROVI, one to watch. SSD. Over 26.27, note that there's a 200-day moving average at 26.43, right? This top line kind of interferes with it. And of course, that's a Bollinger Band above there too. But as you know, lately, things have been running a day or 2 days above it. Now this one, if you look over here in April, when it ran above it before, that was on a gap up. It pulled rapidly back. So if it gaps up over, it's probably not a buy. Unless you do really short-term trading using the 15-minute rule, where there's a link on the homepage to it. Because this increase in volume, again, sideways would be best, and then a breakout above this level is maybe an interesting trade. TAM over 17.05, that was its high just 4 days before. Once again, increased volume on Friday. Looks like they want to push it higher. Note here also, we've got the meeting of the moving averages, 50 and 200 day. If this goes up much more, that 200 day is going to slip below the 50, or the 50 above the 200, whichever way to say it. And that is bullish. And quite often when they meet, there is some fireworks, which means we could see a big move up, or it might be a move down as well if it fails right at this area. But 17.05 is a place to watch. In our opinion now, over 285 would be UEC. You can see 283 is here. That's at the 200-day EMA. So we think if it can get above this, this was a third-day reversal. Remember, we like 3 or 4 days. This is first day, second day. The third day was red for a while down here. It turned green, and that's when it moved up, adding 6%. And that's why it's good when these things can move up. They fail at some resistance, like the 200-day. Quite often, they'll pull down to the 50-day. We call this 250 pinball because it moves back and forth a couple times. And it moved down. They couldn't break below it, so they might as well bring it back up to test the 200. So quite often, they don't break out again. They hit it again another time. But we'll watch and see if it breaks out. That's probably possibility of a buy there. We've got ESE. You can see this is kind of a nice little flag going here. This is a flagpole at a gap up, and then it's built this flag here. Now this also can run out of energy. This is, I believe, to be a type that needs this this excitement going from this gap up to break out again. Now it may only go from this breakout of the flag up to that 3082 once again. So we mentioned that you might be able to buy the break of a flag on good volume, or which is about 3020, or the 3082 would be the top line, paying attention at 3140. But so from this flag, a good run rate would get you in, and then if it looks good and volume increases, maybe it'll break out. If not, you've got a profit built in already. You can get out of it, or get out of part of it at least, and then set your stops accordingly. And lastly, we have this is a penny stock. It was pointed out to us, Griswold pointed out in the chat room. 0.288, and generally we don't pay much attention. Well, we do pay attention sometimes to penny stocks, but this had good volume, 4.5 million shares, and because it hit up against the 50-day, 3 or 4 days before, came back and didn't break down. Quite often the penny stocks, they run into this and break down and maybe make new lows back down to 10 cents or 5 cents, but this didn't. And of course, Discovery Laboratories has been known it years before. It traded at much higher levels, but it's moved back up to the 50, and it may be possibility, because you can see all the up days are higher volume than the down days. Maybe they can finally break above that. You should be experienced in trading penny stocks to trade them, because they are more risky, it seems, sometimes, but they move really volatile at some days, but this hasn't been lately. This has been moving up pretty gradually. Anyway, that's a possibility for you to watch. So we want to thank you for coming by the site. Hope you have a great day trading and a good week as well. Stop in the chat room, say hi, and see what goes on there. And we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.